yourself first of all to all the viewers.
What's going on?
Introduce yourself to all the viewers.
Oh yeah, man, Lil Tommy, man. Y'all go ahead and follow me.
You were the fight ringside. Tito Rosita Lopez, give me your assessment.
Truth be told, it seemed like he got a little winded early. He had rain rust on him. He got caught with a nice left hook. He thought he was out of range, but he wasn't. But he ain't go down. He held it. He came back strong, you know. The dude that had it 113-113, I didn't feel that, but you know, it is what it is. He held it down. He kept it and still.
What is next for Keith Thurman?
Come here with his family.
Okay.
Have a little celebration party and all. That's all I can say. I don't know what's next.
All right, there you have it. Where do people follow you?
Oh yeah, man, Instagram, LittleTommyZ6NE, man. Y'all follow me and shout out to Ellie Setback, doing his thing always.
All right, there you have it, right here at the hotel after the fight.
Yeah.
It was a great night of boxing.
Jose Zito over there.
Let's go talk to him. Let's see what he has to say. Man, Vic, you stranded me. I got stuck in the arena for an hour.
Wow.
You guys should have let me roll with you guys. Josita, what are we eating after the victory?
Some pizza, man. Yeah. Some pizza pie.
Is it with cheese or pepperoni?
What do you? Pepperoni pizza.
Do you feel good now after it's all like?
Body wise, I feel good. I came out fine, no injuries.
Hands okay, that's what matters.
Decision, not so happy, man. I thought I pulled it off. It was a really close fight, but I know how to come in here and really dominate at least 8-9 rounds to really pull off a victory.
You stunned everybody in that round. Just stunned. The whole arena got dead silent. Did you notice that while you were in the ring or not really?
Yeah, I could definitely feel the crowd, the electricity. Man, I love fighting out here in Brooklyn. All the people in Brooklyn are treating me nice, man. I'd love to come back and do it again at Barclays.
What do you tell all your fans and supporters, people who love you and they're watching it?
Well, I appreciate all my supporters, all my fans that have backed me up for a long time. Everybody that came out here, I know a lot of people from Cali and different states really came out here showing support. And, you know, I'm happy, man. We let this one slip away, man, but we're better and improved, so we'll come back.
How did your brother Victor do in the corner? I was watching him.
Nah, he was doing good, man.
He did good. Victor got down.
Victor was good.
He did good in the corner. He looked like a pro. I think Robert might hire him now.
Yeah, no, he might have a
quick with the bucket. I like that. And it's still, I gotta say this though. Always we joke in the gym that you had the longest training camp in the history of Guinness Book of Records. Do you hope to come back in the ring sooner than later, not another 8 months, 10 months, 12 months?
Yeah, man, I definitely would like to fight 3 times this year. You can see me in the summer sometime.
I asked Robert who should Josita fight next. He said maybe Danny Garcia, maybe Sean Porter, maybe the winner of Lipinets Peterson. What do you think of those 3 fights?
I'd love to get a shot at one of the top guys, man. Had a good fight.
You
want to
go around with him?
I had a good fight. I had a good fight with Keith Thurman, but I'd love to get a good shot with one of the other guys. I love fighting, man.
Now, you were 18-1. Imagine if you were 2-1.
I know, right? I know the odds were a little crazy from what I heard, but I was just ready to battle it out with one of the top guys.
What did Robert tell you between rounds? Round one, round two, round three? Was it different instructions or?
No, he was just telling me to be smart, attack, close up, or close in a little bit. You know, keep my guard tight, you know. I think my corner, my team did a hell of a job tonight and throughout training camp.
You know what's crazy? You're just a renation. It's something you don't see every day. It doesn't matter what he threw towards you. You kept coming and coming. What was going through your mind?
Yeah, but I have to really, really dominate for me to pull off a victory if I can't knock him out or stop him. So I really try to win as many rounds as I could.
Some people had you winning. Some people had her draw. Some people had, of course, 2 judges had Keith Thurman winning. He did good. If you had to score a fight, how would Josita Lopez score this fight?
I thought at the end of the fight, when I speak about scoring, I feel like I'm pretty fair. I'm not unrealistic and don't talk all this nonsense. I thought I won 8 rounds. He did catch me with a punch, but I thought I clearly won 8 rounds.
how do the fans and the media people treat you right after the fight?
Oh, great, man. I love fighting out here in Brooklyn, all the Brooklyn people. I love it, man. Barclays was electric. I'm glad that I had an opportunity to fight for Fox, and I'd love to do it again.
Did you have a chance to look at your phone yet?
No.
Can we look at it really quick? How many missed calls? How many text messages?
I don't even want to dare.
Let's see. Let's look at it. I just want to know, what is Josita Lopez's phone? We're not going to show the number, but I just want to see what it looks like. It's still blowing up.
Oh, yeah. It's,
how many?
This is some messages.
A shitload of messages. Are you going to go? Do you respond to everybody or no?
I don't even want to look right now, man. It would take me too long, but... You know, I just make sure to, you know, thank my family, my close family, and eventually I'll get around to everyone else.
I talked to the Big G, he was very proud of you. I talked to Robert, they're very proud of you. They said, look, no one gave us a chance. They thought it would be a two-round fight. Do you still feel that you won no matter what?
You know, it's a little disappointing to come close, man. I've had these opportunities where I've come close, but... I'm tired of coming close, you know. I'm having tough breaks, but I know it's like that when I'm the underdog, when I'm the B side, and I know I have to really do something spectacular to pull off a victory. So, you know, I guess in the judge's eyes, I was a little short, but I thought we did well.
How many punches do you think you threw tonight?
Probably not as much as I should have thrown. I think I could have been a little more active. You know, it was hard to sit down on any punches with his movement, man. He was backing up a lot
did he,
around.
Did he fight like you expected? Is that what you expected him to move like that, or did it?
Yeah. Actually, he was pretty elusive with his movement. You know, he's pretty elusive. He has good boxing ability. And the fight pretty much went almost like I thought, even though we prepared in many different ways. The fight pretty much went kind of how I imagined it.
What was